No, I'm on a special category on an outstanding achievement award, and I'm present in the award as well.
You're the big fastest award.
Yeah, we'll take it home. Yeah, why not?
Okay, now, people have been watching your movies, and they're like, when they watch you on a TV show, they're like, what is your career going to be up to? So what are you up to now, 2010?
Well, I got a lot of stuff, which I'm not going to talk about, because as a Christian, you don't go letting the cat out of the bag until it's done, you know?
Okay, now, you have to go deck up all on gold.
Ooh. Well, I got it myself. I bought it when I traveled to US. It's not been too long. I came back. It's a Versace, and you know, I got myself, you know, ready that in case we have something doing. Why not? I come looking gorgeous. And you know, gold is my signature. They call me UK Gold. You know, so that's. On CRBC. I'm watching the red carpet show on CRBC. Thank you.
Everybody wants to talk to him, but he must come on CRBC and say one of the things. You know the way it is with these celebrities. If you don't pinch them and click them down, they're just going to run away. DJ Jimmy Jazz is standing right beside me. I will definitely not allow him to escape the CRBC TV interview. Of course, you've been coming to watch him a couple of times.
Oh, definitely. Yes. I've been to the station several times. I'm all right.
Okay.
Good to see you.
Nice to see you.
Yeah.
I'm so happy you're on my feed and you're having a one-on-one chat.
I'm so glad to see you in Lagos. I thought you guys only called a little, you know,
okay.
That actually. Yeah.
Okay. Tell us about your outfit. I mean,
nothing. I mean, it's just.
You're putting on red and black.
Yes.
So
that's what I could lay my hand on quickly.
Okay.
Yeah.
So now you're here for the Critical Awards 2010. It's about celebrating creativity and excellence in music and movies.
Yes.
You are one person everybody reckons in the entertainment industry. Just give us a few tracks to talk about who Jimmy Jazz is.
I'm a DJ, first of all. I mean, I'm a Nigerian. They're not too much about me. You know, I'm like I said, I'm a DJ. I'm a Nigerian. You know, so.
There's something about your style that's uniquely different from other DJs.
Okay.
Where do you get your inspiration from? Is it from God? Is it from the criteria around you?
Most definitely, first of all, you can't ignore for everything you do in life, you must recognize the fact that it's God's grace and all that, you know. So that comes from there. And of course, you tap a whole lot of strength and energy from the vibe you feel from people, you know. So for me, it's the love and appreciation I get from fans and people generally, plus the grace of God.
This icon has actually been on the entertainment scene for decades. Now, let's ask him this question.
Yes, ma'am.
You are a celebrity. How do you cope with the press acclaim? I mean, you're going here, you want 6 DJ Jimmy Jazz. I just saw you and I was like, wow, I want to have your job. How do you cope with the acclaim?
I think, first of all, you need to realize that if people don't love you, they don't care about you, they don't want to be with you. You know, so if people really want to talk to you and they want to interview you, that's because they love you and they appreciate you. So you need to respect and appreciate that in return. So for me, I'm always glad to, you know.
Looking at the TV and the movie industry and the music industry, would you say it has met the expectations so far? Are we creative people?
We're very creative people. We've always been creative people. It's just that it took a long time for Nigerians to believe in Nigerians. It was at one time, people would want to say something is Nigerian, they feel it's inferior. You know, but now that's change, you know. Everybody's wearing Nigerian clothes. Everybody's listening to Nigerian music. Everybody's, you know, doing a whole lot of watching Nigerian movies and all that. But before, it wasn't really, you know, fashionable or hip to say, man, I'm dealing with Niger, you know. So we've changed all that mentality, and I think that's a great thing, you know.
DJ Gasparilla, Nigeria's foremost gospel music DJ in the building.
Nigeria's foremost gospel DJ in the building.
In the building.
Okay, now how are you feeling at this point in time? You're here for the Critical Awards 2010.
I'm high. I'm expecting so much things. And by the time I go inside, I know city people is not going to let me down. Normally they do things the right way. Because I'm the right person, I go to the right places to see the right things.
Okay, now, looking at the Critical Awards, the global idea here is star, music, and movies.
Yes.
Looking at star, what is your favorite sound? who is your favorite star icon? Your favorite star at Tesla. Who is your favorite star icon?
Me.
Yeah.
Me.
Okay?
Me.
Wow.
I'm my own favorite person. I'm my own favorite style icon. You know, I just put on stuff that I want to put on, that looks good on me, that makes me feel comfortable. I don't believe in names. You understand? You know, designer names and all that. I design my stuff and I wear my stuff.
The designer, the product.
Everything I'm wearing, I ask my tailor to make for me. And so I design for myself. Thank you very much.
Whether you like it or not, it is your RBT. Cross River State. You actually come for Carnival. Nice to meet you. Nice to meet you, Chinedu Ikedieze. Whether you like it or not, Chinedu Ikedieze is a celebrity. Chinedu Ikedieze is a force to reckon with. Talking about Nollywood, Chinedu Ikedieze has been able to stand for footmark that is uniquely his. It's good to have you on CRBC.
Oh, thank you very much.
Popularly called.
Okay.
Okay, so how are you feeling at this point in time?
I'm just feeling good, my brother.
You're here for the beautiful award.
Yeah.
That's about twice and you. And you have the Nigerian logo on you.
Of course, truly Nigerian.
Okay, so I like your sense of humor on TV. You have the ability to make people laugh. Where do you get this inspiration from?
From God. Where else?
Okay. Now, looking at the TV and the music industry, would you say so far they have been able to meet up your expectations? You've been on the scene for a very long time. What do you have to say about the music industry, although you're not a musician?
No, honestly, the music industry has been able to meet up with my expectations and other people's expectations. They've come of age and they're doing well, both in local level and international scale.
Okay, now, looking at the movie industry, there are so many things that need to be incorporated to get the movie industry forward. Now, mention one thing you feel people who watch Nollywood should do, and people who are into the
we need to do a lot.
Okay.
We need to restructure the whole thing.
Thank you so much. I'm Kennison Brown, but these days I like to be called KSB. I'm an office.
So many people out there are just despising the Nollywood industry that we are not doing, we are not making up the expectations.
I disagree with you, because if we're not doing something out of nothing, because you really have to check what is on ground, what has the government put in place for the people, for the industry to flourish. What? How many corporate bodies are out there the way they support football to say, hey, we want to nurture? So these people are doing all this from their own pocket, from their own sweat. And it's okay to criticize, because criticism makes you do well. It makes you to improve. So it's not for you to start to say, hey, because if not, we cannot. You cannot ask DSTV the kind of revenue they're making from Nollywood. I mean, it's so huge now that they now have Yoruba Channel, they have Hausa Channel, and now Igbo Channel is coming. And you see, have two movie magic. I mean, the African Magic One, African Magic Plus. Hey, all of these came from Nollywood. 6 years ago, we didn't have anything like that. But these people kept working. And now come to the music industry. 3 years ago, no, let me say like 5 years ago, there was no MTV base. And if we're not working, they wouldn't come to Africa. They smelt us from afar that this, something is cooking in Nigeria. Something is brewing. And they have to just quickly plug in so that they also, because they're making money from it. You know, we are creating content for a global viewer, both in the music industry and Nollywood. Hey, please.
Ladies and gentlemen, I go by the name of Banky W.
And I go by the name S to the K-A-L-E-S, Gale.
We represent EME Records, and we're wishing you a wonderful time. This is Red Carpet on CRBC TV.